Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Before we get started, make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe to my channel. Does AI know when you are hurt and help you? So make sure to watch the full video. These systems are known as emotion AI. Artificial intelligence is the general name for devices that mimic human thought processes. Emotion AI is a kind of artificial intelligence that measures, comprehends, replicates, and responds to human emotions. Affective computing and artificial emotional intelligence are other names for it. Rosalind Picard of the MIT Media Lab published Affective Computing in 1995, marking the beginning of the era. Emotion AI is a tool that enables a much more organic relationship between humans and machines, according to Javier Hernandez, a research scientist with the MIT Media Lab's Affective Computing Group. Hernandez added, "Consider how you interact with other people. You look at their faces, you look at their bodies, and you change your interaction accordingly. How a machine can effectively communicate information if it doesn't know your emotional state, if it doesn't know how you're feeling, if it doesn't know how you're going to respond to specific content. In spite of the fact that humans may be better at reading emotions, machines are advancing thanks to their advantages." Professor Erik Brynjolfsson of MIT Sloan said that machines are excellent at evaluating vast amounts of data. They can learn to listen for speech inflections and begin identifying those that are associated with tension or rage. Machines are capable of picture analysis, which enables them to discern minor micro-expressions on people's faces that may occur too quickly for a person to see. In our brains, there are many neurons dedicated to social interactions. We are born with some of such abilities, and we later acquire more. Utilizing technology to engage our social brains, as well as our analytical brains, makes sense, declared Brynjolfsson. In the same way that we understand speech and machines can speak verbally, we also comprehend and communicate with humor and other types of emotions. And machines that are capable of speaking that language, the language of emotions, will communicate with us in a better, more efficient way. It's nice that we've made some progress. But it's simply that now that it's an option. It wasn't before 20 or 30 years ago. Which fields are already utilizing emotion AI? Advertising. In 2009, Rana El Kelioubi, PhD 06, and Picard established Affectiva, a Boston-based emotion AI business that focuses in automotive AI and advertising research, the latter of which serves 25% of Fortune 500 firms. Our technology captures these visceral, subconscious reactions, El Kelioubi said. We have found that these reactions strongly correlate with actual consumer behavior, like sharing the ad or actually purchasing the product. Once a client has been thoroughly screened and accepted the terms of Affectiva's use, such as promising not to exploit the technology for surveillance or lie detection, the client is granted access to Affectiva's technology in the context of advertising research. The technology, when used with a customer's permission, uses the phone or laptop camera to record their reactions to a specific commercial. Self-reporting is useful, such as feedback from a test group, according to El Kelioubi, but having a real-time response enables marketers to determine whether a specific advertisement resonated with viewers or offended them, or whether it was confusing or touched a sensitive nerve. Call centers. Cogito, a startup co-founded in 2007 by alumni of MIT Sloan, provides technology that enables call center representatives to recognize the emotional states of their callers and modify their approach in real time. Years of research into human behavior have been used to develop Cogito's voice analytics software, which recognizes vocal patterns. Mental health. In December 2018, Cogito unveiled CompanionX, a division with a companion app for tracking one's mental health. The companion app hears someone talk into their phone while monitoring the speaker's phone usage and voice for indications of anxiety and mood swings. The app helps users become more self-aware and can develop their coping mechanisms, including techniques for stress management. The business has collaborated with the Massachusetts General Hospital, Brigham, and Women's Hospital, and the Department of Veterans Affairs. Another feeling wearable equipment created by the MIT Media Lab that analyzes a person's heartbeat to determine their level of stress, discomfort, or annoyance is an example of AI-driven mental health technology. In order to help the wearer cope with the unpleasant emotion they are currently experiencing, the monitor then releases a smell. When tension or discomfort is detected, the bioessence wearable emits perfume to help the user cope with the unpleasant feeling. While the outside of the car has received a lot of attention with regard to safety, there are many distractions inside that can also affect safety. Think about a vehicle that could detect when a driver was arguing with the person sitting next to them by detecting an increase in blood pressure and reducing the driver's speed. Or a sensor that alerted the driver's wheel to gently steer the vehicle into the middle of the lane when it had unintentionally listed to the curb due to lack of sleep. Similar automotive AI services are offered by Affectiva, which tracks a driver's emotional state and the experiences of passengers to enhance traffic safety and the occupant experience. Assistive services. Some autistic individuals struggle to emotionally communicate. This is where Emotion AI can act as a kind of assistive technology. According to Hernandez, wearable sensors can detect subtleties in body language or facial expressions in an autistic person, such as an elevated heart rate, that others might not be able to observe. Additionally, according to Hernandez, there are communicative prostheses that teach autistic people how to read facial expressions in others. A game where the player must identify smiley or frowny faces on the people around them is one illustration. Hernandez said, that is a way for them to interact with others and also learn how facial expressions work. He added that this video technology, which detects moods in smiley or frowny faces, could be useful for gathering customer feedback in crowded theme parks or hospital waiting rooms, as well as for giving upper management anonymous feedback in a large office. Should we be happy or concerned about Emotion AI? Hernandez advised any company interested in implementing this technology to foster a positive dialogue about its advantages, what is achievable with it, and how to use it privately. Hernandez advised businesses to consider what elements of emotional intelligence should play a critical role in your business. Can technology be used for that kind of emotional engagement, and how would that change? Elkaliubi claimed that she sees possibilities in the technology being expanded to new use cases, such as employing call center technology to comprehend the emotional wellness of employees or for other mental health purposes. But the worry of coming across as Big Brother is a real one, and it will need to be constantly addressed in the context of privacy in this technology. To that point, Elkaliubi stated that Affectiva needs consent and opt-in for every application of its technology. The technology is only as good as its coder, which is another thing to bear in mind. As these technologies are implemented, Brynjolfsson cautioned that they must be suitable for all people and not just sensitive to the population subset used for training. For instance, Brynjolfsson explained, a machine trained on Caucasian faces sometimes finds it challenging to recognize emotions in an African-American face. And some gestures or voice inflections that mean one thing in one culture may mean something entirely different in another. Overall, it's crucial to keep in mind that when applied thoughtfully, technology benefits can and should outweigh costs, according to Brynjolfsson and Elkaliubi, who also stressed the feasibility of thoughtful technology integration. The paradigm, according to her, is actually a person-enhancing machine rather than human-vis-machine. It is a human and a machine. So that's it for today. We hope you enjoyed the video. Use the comments section below to tell us your thoughts about the video. Also, make sure to subscribe to our channel and click the bell button to be notified of all the latest videos.